the Philadelphia Eagles. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by the former Heisman Trophy winner and number one overall pick from Oklahoma. It's Sam Bradford.
And Sam Bradford, he has touch and accuracy, and he has it in bushels. This guy is amazing. If you watch him throw 7-on-7 or watch him throw routes versus air, the ball hardly ever hits the ground. He's absolutely a receiver's dream when going out for a pass.
They come out here in the eye. They begin the drive with Ryan Matthews. And he'll get across the 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And a peek at the offense. And Matthews, a guy that we have to talk about.
And Jordan Matthews, Brandon, is an anomaly. Normally, a long receiver plays outside. He likes to work out of the slot. Does a terrific job absorbing punishment and catching the football.
Now it's a bootleg with Bradford. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Ryan Kerrigan in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Third and long for Bradford. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he's eventually brought down, but not before he reaches the 39, just shy of the 40. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
This is the veteran fullback, John Kuhn. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And here is the Redskin defense.
Ryan Kerrigan is an example of bringing the best of you from college to the NFL and remaking your game. Terrific guy causing fumbles at Purdue, has done the exact same thing in the NFL, then lost weight and became an absolute terror rushing the passer.
And some room to work. And he cuts it out to the sideline. And all the way down to the 7-yard line. A big play there for Philly. And even 50 yards. So he rips off a great run and shows you why this year he's top 10 in rushing in the league.
And looks like he's trying to move up fast on the leaderboard, doesn't he? Top 10? Looks like he's running to get into the top 5.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. And they'll run it here. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Ryan Matthews, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone, they do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves, sticking it in the end zone on a running play.
A drive that time of 6 plays, and it's Ryan Matthews finishing it off with a touchdown run. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. Marshall now, the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Up. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time, and that'll bring up second down. Now McCoy ducks him with a grab over the middle. That catch good for 5. It's third down. So here we go, a 3rd down after the 2nd down pass completion.
Let's go! 3-19!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. It's brought in by Dodson. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Again, they run with Sims. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
I can't help it. I'm just sitting back in admiration right now. This defense tells everyone that plays against them, you're not beating us running the football. That's who we are. That's what we're about. It's not going to happen. If you're going to beat us, you better pick another way.
They'll set up a throw. And this is caught by Jackson. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And now a 1st down following that long gain.
Okay, what can't DeSean Jackson do? All right, we know about the catches. We just saw another one there. Also gets involved in the return game. And he can break big plays like that. We've seen him do it throughout his NFL career.
We have. What are you thinking of anything in particular?
I'm still remembering a certain Giants punter not following orders. And DeSean Jackson made that big-time return all the way back for a game winner in that one. I still remember seeing the looks of disbelief on the Giants sideline.
Live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number 2, but they face a 2nd and long to start things out.
Let's go.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. A dump off to Sims. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
Pushing a foul, roughing the passer, defense.
Roughing the passer, that's shades of Charles Davis back in his playing days.
Oh, I sure wish it had been, Brandon. Back in my day, I didn't hit anyone hard enough to rough the passer. I had a number of teammates that handled that for me.
They'll run it again with Sims. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll run here with Sims. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. It's the fullback, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play, and guess what? They took a shot. are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
Here we go now. 390.
Second down, Bradford. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. And it'll bring up third down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Buying time to his left, and he connects with Ertz. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And when he started rolling left there as a right-handed quarterback, I thought, boy, this third down play is going nowhere. But credit to him, able to pick up the first.
And all you righties who are watching the game at home, get out of your chair, get off the couch, move to your left, and then rifle one. He may leave a hole in the wall, as you have to explain later, but you'll see how difficult that throw actually was.
Bradford now to throw on first down. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bashaun Breeland. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Second down following the run.
Here we go now. Blue 90.
Now they run with Sims. And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Now McCoy docks him with a grab over the middle. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Here's McCoy. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield. We don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back. I mean, maybe even check it down, whatever you want to call it. Gain of 5. You're just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Sims. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. Now on fourth down, the 2014 NFL leader as a rookie in yards per punt, Tress Way, on to kick it. Back deep to return it is Lucky Whitehead. This is taken at the 18. Look at the spin.
Balance.
A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. Now the number three pick in 2012, it's Trent Richardson. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Let's go, let's bring it, let's bring it.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now Bradford on second down. He's going to air it out deep for Matthews. That's caught inside the 20. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. And Myers able to knock it through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Eagles are looking good right now as they will just try to keep up the good work in the second half. The Redskins are coming off a bad game, and they haven't been able to get out of that funk here today. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half.
And actually, Larry, hold that thought. We're right back to the action. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And here come the Redskins now. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some.
And a loose football caught on the right side. Reed. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And they came out of the locker trailing. Not a good way to start this second half with their first drive.
Can't imagine that the discussion at halftime encompassed this at all. In fact, I'm sure they talked about, okay, kind of wipe the slate clean, start the second half, and let's go out and play the way we know that we can. That's not a great example of it.
They didn't envision that. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met. I'm still an old school football guy, and anytime you see a big time running play, that fires me up. And if I'm on offense right now, in the position they're in now, inside the 10-yard line, I think after the way they've run it, they've set themselves up for a good play action pass opportunity right here.
Now it's Richardson. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll try and run it in. It's Richardson. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the four-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the seven. And a loss of three to bring up four.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. Now Bradford, he rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Charles Sims, the intended target. And now it's second down.
And there's a good opportunity that just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Now back to throw. And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete. Here's Tressway now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
On second down, Bradford again. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people... We're trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And the Redskins have an extra man in the secondary here on third. To throw is Bradford. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Charles, when plays like that work, it's a thing to behold, but sometimes we see why they're very deep in the playbook.
And how many times have we been at practice and heard all the other guys chirping about, you know, I used to play quarterback in high school, I can do this, until it becomes a game situation. Not quite the same in many cases.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Now Sims. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. So they go out of the gun, try to delay it on the draw, but nothing there.
Yeah, good play by the defense there. They sniffed it out and made sure there were no gaps for him to run. If you're the offense, though, you have to think to yourself, maybe I go play action down the road.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give them a new set of downs.
2nd and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on 3rd down and pick up the 1st down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the 1st down. That's exactly what they did.
5 yards on the catch there brings up 2nd down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the 1st tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
So the scoring dried up here in the 3rd. Nothing that cold. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. It's hauled in by Doxson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And he was able to find a very soft spot in that zone coverage.
I love that term, Brandon. That soft spot where you find the open area, set up, and catch the football before the hard collision comes afterwards.
And they'll go with the ground attack here. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there. 2nd down.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15. Nigel Branham brings him down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. 1st level defensive line, 2nd level linebackers, 3rd level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a 1st level run, and it was stopped by a 2nd level player.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up 4th down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. Hey, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This one from 35 yards away. And Hopkins' kick is good. And in the 4th quarter, this game is tied. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the 4th quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And 3 interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, the number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do?
Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Trent Richardson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Eagles have moved out in front. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Now Myers for the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down. And that pick just sets him up beautifully right down near the goal line.
I remember being in a defensive meeting back when I was in college, and our defensive coordinator says, we're going to call this Be Who You Are defense. D linemen, you play the run. Linebackers, be aware of anything. And secondary, you play the pass. That way, you're all set, ready for whatever they put out there.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here. And he's in. Broad Eagles touchdown. Trent Richardson with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. The bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Well, they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. And it's a short kick, taken right around the 19. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So out now come the Redskins. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
Roughing the pass here, but Charles, that's a good call. But these days, you know quarterbacks, they're very protective.
We know how protected they are, and if it's anything borderline, they're going to get the call. But as a defender, that's hard to swallow sometimes because there's so many of these bang-bang plays.
And they'll get him down here at about the 42. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Now McCoy. He's got the hook up to Andre Holmes. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. And give him a gain of 37.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this. But run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So it's Redskin football here as we welcome you back. They've got it 1st and goal as they look to punch in a late score. Here's McCoy. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. DeSean Jackson scoring a touchdown against his former mates. And the Redskins have made this a one-score game.
And they put it in the end zone, which was job one. Now they have to convert. And then it's decision time, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. This is what all teams go through. You look at the clock, you're inside 2 minutes. Look at your timeouts. Make that onside kick decision.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense, where you are in terms of the scoreboard and the time left on the clock? As you noted, so many things to go through.
We focus our attention on the Redskins defense now. They do have all three timeouts remaining, but a first down likely ends this thing.
And it looks like they are, to coin a phrase, on the defensive here, right?
And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskins defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Throwing here, Bradford. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Fresh set of downs here. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Richardson, and he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
Double tight, guys. Double tight. Three down. Three down.
On the ground, here's Richardson again. A beautiful spin and room to run. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's a pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there. We see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this guy, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Bradford. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Bashaun Breeland. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. I'm surprised with the lead in a one-score game this late, they're even putting the ball in the air in that situation.
Almost makes me feel like the head coach might be second-guessing himself by not clicking on and saying, all we're doing is running it here. But give credit to the guys on defense. They made a play that they absolutely had to have to give themselves a chance to be in this game.
Call it a gain of five, and that'll make it second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And with just over 40 seconds now remaining, he gets up and spikes it. Third down and five. Throw. And this is going to be incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Josh Doctson, and it's fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. Jordan Reed has it. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 26 yards on the play there. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And now they're in the hurry up. And under 20 seconds now as the spike comes with 18 ticks remaining.
Let's go! 3-19!
They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty.